唔係。好，咁啊。
Members, good afternoon. We've formed a quorum and it's also the appointed time. We welcome members to the meeting of the panel on information technology and broadcasting. The chair is otherwise engaged and I'm standing in and welcome members to the meeting. The first thing on the agenda is information papers issued since the last meeting. There is one from the Secretariat. Please refer to the agenda for details. It's about incorrect national anthem played at international games. It was a letter dated the 3rd of April, 2023. The proper national anthem was not played at international games, and Dr. Junius Ho has written to the chief executive on that matter. Mr. Chen, are you going to speak on this item? All right. That is just for your information. A letter sent by the chairman to the chief executive. The second item is discussion for our next meeting scheduled for the 12th of June, a Monday, at 2:30 at room 3. The proposed item for discussion is funding proposals of Cyberport on supporting the development of startups and promotion of digital transformation. Members, do you agree that it will be the only item for discussion at the next meeting? All right. And may I report to you that the chair has discussed with the Secretary for Commerce and Economic Development, and the Secretary is going to put together a visit for us to RTHK in June. And then in November, we're going to meet the in charges of overseas ETOs, and we will discuss with them how they can tell good stories of Hong Kong through ETOs. And the third item is progress of work of Cyberport. Please invite the representatives to come in. Members, if you wish to ask questions, please press the button. Welcome, Mr. Lillian Chong, Undersecretary for Innovation, Technology and Industry, Charmaine and Eric and Alice, and also the CEO from Hong Kong Cyberport. I believe we have a PowerPoint presentation. While we are waiting for the PowerPoint to play, now we have six members who have indicated their wish to ask questions. All right, there are seven. Each will have up to 4 minutes. Undersecretary, over to you. Thank you, Chair. Innovation and technology is one of the major impetus for further economic development. The National 14-5-year plan has clearly positioned Hong Kong as an international INT hub, and that is the new role to be played by Hong Kong. And then come the 1st of July last year, President Xi once again recognized the importance of Hong Kong in the country's overall development. And then in the report to the 20th National People's Congress, President said that we must use innovation technology to prosper the country, and we must build up our own talent pool so as to enhance the INT capability of the country. We are committed to developing Hong Kong into an international INT center. Last year, we launched a blueprint for INT development with four major directions. We should improve our own INT ecosystem. We should promote reindustrialization. We must enlarge our talent pool and to enhance economic impetus. And we should promote smart living so that Hong Kong can leverage the advantage of having the support of the country and being well connected to the world. Cyberport is an important infrastructure for INT development, and it has spent no effort in helping us to build an INT ecosystem. It has been successful in building up one, and in terms of nurturing and supporting startups, it has achieved a lot. So far, the Cyberport has seen the development of six unicorns, one of which was listed in June 2022. And since 2010, the Cyberport community has attracted over $35.6 billion of investment. And Cyberport has been enhancing its public mission programs. Compared with 2017-18, it has increased funding in this area by 50%. Cyberport will continue to launch measures to help startups to scale new heights. Now I invite the CEO of Cyberport, Mr. Peter Yam, to give us a briefing of the work of Cyberport. Myself and also the Cyberport team will be most happy to take questions from members afterwards. Mr. Peter Yan, thank you. Am I coming through? Before we give you an update of our work, let us show you a short video clip to give you an overall view of what Cyberport has been doing. Success. How can we attain success? If you believe in innovation, in changing the world, then here lies the answer. We nurture INT talents, we encourage startups, we provide support for them and promote development of industries and integration of old and new industries. We also enhance cooperation with international partners. Our objective is to be an organization committed to promoting INT and to build up an ecosystem and a community for promoting INT to give new impetus to our economy. Welcome to Cyberport. Cyberport is a place for entrepreneurs to showcase their creativity, to allow enterprises and technology companies to connect. We have a range of measures to support startups. Every year we have flagship activities to help enterprises to realize their dreams. The Cyberport Academy has got a university program providing training for talents. With the support of the Startup Fund from Cyberport, we are now able to upgrade and transform our business. Through the incubation program of Cyberport, we obtain funding, support, and we have development opportunities. We're now a virtual insurance company in Hong Kong. With the support of the Cyberport Accelerator Fund, we have got funding support, and we have now grown. Under MDSS, we have successfully extended a business to the mainland and overseas. Cyberport, the venture capital fund has helped us to play a bigger role in the relevant market. Now we are in a technology-driven society. Cyberport has promoted development of the use of fintech, digital, smart living, digital entertainment, and fintech. AI, big data, cybersecurity, and blockchain are getting more important. This is the best time for us to develop our creativity. We'll continue to grow and must be flexible and embrace changes, and surely we can achieve our goals. To realize your dreams, you need to persevere. You may encounter challenges. So long as you're willing to follow your dreams, for sure there will be a way out. Our vast network and experience will help you to the way to success and help you realize your dreams with creativity. From Hong Kong, you're going to march out to the world. Thank you. Are you going to show us a PPT presentation? Yes, I'm going to spend about 10 minutes. Please do so within 10 minutes so that we have time for members to ask questions. Perhaps I should start first. As shown on the short video, Cyberport is committed to the development of digital technology. On development of digital technology, we want to give new impetus to our economic growth so that there will be more development in industries related to INT. We focus on the training of talents, on the development of industries, and on the integration of old and new economies. We have different schemes and programs to work on these three areas. We want to promote economic development in Hong Kong through our programs. Now, cumulatively, we have about 1,900 companies in our community. 800 of them are stationed at Cyberport. Outside Cyberport, we have some that are our incubatees because they can choose to station at Cyberport or outside. For those who are in Cyberport, we provide 2 years of free office space. As regards our application community and our technology communities, they have three focuses. Respectively, including fintech, smart living, and digital entertainment. In our technology group, we mainly focus on AI, blockchain, and cybersecurity. In the past few years, we have achieved some results. As mentioned by the Undersecretary, we, among the dozen or so unicorns in Hong Kong, 6 were nurtured by Cyberport, and 1 got listed last year, Google X, which is familiar to you. We also complement financial industry policies of the government. I will elaborate on that later. For promotion of fintech, we have got 400-odd fintech companies. We have become the largest fintech cluster in Hong Kong. You might have come across fintech companies operating in Cyberport. And we've done quite well in the past few years. As I mentioned, of the 6 unicorns, 3 are in the financial services sector. with the promotion of the policies formulated by the Financial Services and Treasury Bureau, we have achieved a lot in the following three areas. Now, we have launched the licensed virtual bank, and the first two are from Cyberport, including ZN and also Relen. And then we have also got, the government has also issued four licenses for virtual insurance companies. Three out of the four were nurtured by Cyberport. Just last October, there was the promulgation of the statement on promotion of asset, virtual asset. And we've also got one company which has successfully obtained a license. The Bureau has got various programs, including some that are very familiar to you, and that's the FinTech Proof of Concept Subsidy Scheme.
Another important area is smart living under the smart city theme. We have been committed to promoting smart living so that the general public can feel the benefits brought by INT to their lives. We have the biggest cluster under smart living. At Cyberport, we have about 760 startups under smart living, and seven of the unicorns at Cyberport are in the smart living cluster. Also, there are various schemes implemented by the government. One of them you may be familiar with is the subsidy scheme for encouraging early development of 5G. A lot of companies at Cyberport under the smart living cluster have made use of the subsidy scheme and turned their operation by making use of the 5G technology. And these companies have won a number of awards, including the Hong Kong ICT Awards. Every year, they together win some 30 awards. The last area that we focus on is digital and entertainment. We have about 170 digital entertainment related companies, and we have nurtured some unicorns under this cluster. Over the past 6 months, with the third generation internet development, we have seen an increase in the number of such companies. We will see more of these companies under the cluster in the future. Every year, we have a digital flagship event. It's called the Digital Entertainment Leadership Forum. We continued to hold the forum even during COVID, and we launched a virtual version of the forum. And we also held a forum in the hybrid format over the past few years. We have esports events in collaboration with the West Kowloon Cultural District, and we've seen some good developments in these areas. Vivian Tam is a well-known designer in Hong Kong, and she has established a East West company at Cyberport. It is a fashion technology company. Last year, we worked with, early this year, we worked with her, and in the Fashion Week in New York, we rolled out a fashion show in Metaverse this year. And it was set in the Hong Kong streets in a virtual backdrop, and we helped to promote this company to the world, and this is the first time we held such a metaverse fashion show with a company. As elaborated in the short clip just now, we have a core nurturing program. There are different stages to our programs. We have collaborated with universities in Hong Kong, and we rolled out a program called Cyberport University Partnership Program. Every year, there are university students who took part in this program, who has the opportunity to set up their business in Hong Kong. Those who won the awards can get a funding of $10,000, $100,000. They can also attend a one-week intensive course under the program about entrepreneurship. And they can take this opportunity to visit various universities. We visited the Stanford University, Chicago University, and this year we work with the University of Cambridge. Apart from local, well-known, prestigious universities, we also work with renowned universities overseas. Apart from rolling out programs for university students, we also welcome individuals and companies to participate a so-called Cyberport creative micro fund, and they can turn their innovative ideas into prototypes under the fund. They can also take part in the incubation program to obtain a funding of $500,000. There are also accelerator support programs which will continue to offer support to the companies. So there are together $1.1 million to offer financial assistance to them. We've also set up a Cyberport macro fund, and we have allocated $450 million for investing in various companies. Please speed up, Peter. On the achievement that we have attained, we have invested in some 25 companies in the past. What was most important is that we have brought some funding, eightfold funding, to Cyberport. So far, we have accumulated funding of $35.6 billion raised by Cyberport startups. Also, we have won various awards, and in the international arena, we have won some 200 awards, and locally and internationally, we have won over 1,000 awards. On nurturing talents, we have various schemes rolled out as well, including internship programs as well as talent supporting schemes. In total, we have over 1,000 employment opportunities created through these programs. What is worth mentioning is that we also have a Greater Bay Area Youth Employment Scheme, and we saw the participation of quite a number of participating companies, and we have created over 100 job opportunities. And to tie in with the development blueprint rolled out by the government, we also have measures to compete for enterprises and talents. Apart from the giant companies, we have attracted over the past few months, we have attracted a retail technology company called Bmall to establish presence at Cyberport, and they will build an AI lab in Hong Kong. In other science parks on the mainland or science parks in overseas, we also work with them, including the one in Shanghai and the Future Foundation in Dubai, etc. we also strive to more closely liaise with the INT ecosystem in the mainland. And for that purpose, we have strengthened collaboration with the organizations in the mainland. Apart from the original GBA programs we have, we also worked with large enterprises such as Hang Seng and China Resources Group. The last slide here. I'd like to talk about the Cyberport expansion project we have implemented. Previously, thanks to the support of members in the LegCo, we got the funding to launch this expansion project. We will finish the foundation works within this month. It will further strengthen our support on developing INT space and will build a 36,000 square meter big INT space, and a lot of companies will be able to benefit from the space. We'll also set up a data services platform of 10,500 square meters, and we will implement digital economy related infrastructure and facilities. It looks like a lab, and companies can try out various facilities in the lab. That's all for my briefing. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Peter. We have 9 members who have pressed the button to speak. They are Mr. Chen Kin Po, Mr. Lam Chen Sing, Mr. Peter Xu, Mr. Dennis Leung, Ms. Elizabeth Kwok, Dr. Lo Wai Kwok, Mr. Michael Luke, and Mr. Eunice Yong. 4 minutes for each member, questions and answers included. Let's begin with Mr. Chen Kin Po. Paragraph 10 of the government papers mentions that in 2018, there is a overseas mainland market development support scheme. Where did the participating startup go under this support scheme, and what are the outcomes achieved under the scheme? This is my first question. Also, my second question is related to paragraph 21 of the paper. It's about smart living. About 700 social innovation startups is engaging in smart living. We're seeing an aging society in Hong Kong, and 30% of our population will be 65 years old or above. How can we make use of technology to help the elderly people or encourage elderly people to make use of technology? This is a huge topic. I'm not seeing any efforts in this regard because people have been focusing on using technology in education or in healthcare. So I wonder if you can create an platform with the interface that it's friendly enough for elderly people to use so that they can improve their lives through the use of technology. We often say that elderly people are lonely. We've always heard people saying loneliness can kill us. If we can help elderly people to make use of digital technology to join the community, then I think it will offer a lot of help to them. 2 questions, Undersecretary. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Mr. Chen, for the question. On the first question, that is how we promote our scheme overseas and in the mainland, I'll defer to the CEO. And on the second question about smart living, currently we have 770 enterprises. About 200 of them are related to e-com, and 180 about education technology, and 100 about or in Internet of Things. I understand that Mr. Chen is concerned about how we can encourage the use of technology by elderly, and the government is concerned about this as well. Apart from nurturing people to use technology, under the OGO, we also have an academy. Well, there are 11 of them. About 11 of them that offer support to organizations to hold various events to teach elderly people so that they can learn how to use, for instance, digital or electronic payment, and also use technology in healthcare. We also have Jern Technology Learning Station and also other events that encourage the use of technology by the elderly. We thank Mr. Chen for the suggestions. We will think about how we can make use of the facilities and technologies we have at Cyberport and integrate them with the services in community to promote the use of technology among elderly.
Over to the CEO. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chen, for your questions. On overseas market expansion, since 2020, we have already provided over $1 million support. So based on the need, they can apply for up to $200,000 of subsidy per case. So we also assess the outcome of their marketing activities. We also keep in view changes in the market and lead overseas market development programs. For instance, we once organized a trip to Scandinavian countries to look for business for them, and then because of development in Metaverse, we did that. And you mentioned German technology. We visited Japan on a mission trip. When it comes to fintech, whether it be virtual banks or virtual insurance companies, we went to Japan and Thailand. Now, due to time constraints, each member can have only 4 minutes. Perhaps you can provide a paper later. Just one more sentence, Chair. Hopefully, they can have KPIs for overseas market expansion or development programs. Yes, the number of participants and also the outcome. Give us a paper on that afterwards. Thank you, Mr. Chen Xiuhong. Thank you. The Cyberport has done very well. There are already 6 unicorns from their startups. At the first, successfully got listed last year. We really recognize the work of the Cyberport. I'd like to ask a rather high-level question. On promotion of INT, we have the Cyberport, the INT industrial park, etc. Cyberport specializes in digital technology, and Cyberport in high new technology. Has there been any assessment to ensure there is no overlapping of roles? For instance, in Paragraph 16, it is said that Cyberport focuses on promotion of fintech, digital entertainment, and smart living. The INT Park set up the fintech center in Kowloon 2 years ago. The corporation so they would like to build a technology ecosystem for fintech. And in the budget, $260 million has been set aside for a smart living development program. And Cyberport also, the corporation also wants to promote smart living. So there is a similar platform here. Given that resources are limited, how does the Bureau ensure proper consolidation on coordination of resources so that there can be beneficial competition between the two organizations? Thank you. Yes, Positioning and Division of Labor, Under Secretary. Thank you, Mr. Chen, for giving us this excellent reminder as to how we can enhance our INT ecosystem and how different R&D organizations can complement one another. Now, Hong Kong has got four major industries where we have advantage. That is AI and also big data, and then fintech, and then biotechnology, and also advanced manufacturing. These are important targets for our development. Different organizations have division of labor to promote our development in these four areas so that we can build up a healthy ecosystem. For fintech, Cyberport for sure is a pioneer. Within a few years, it has already built up the biggest fintech cluster in Hong Kong. It has got over 400 fintech companies and among the biggest in Asia. Cyberport will continue to promote fintech development in Hong Kong. And we've also got the Science Park, which is involved. They can support one another in terms of technology. But fintech has always been one of the specialized areas of Cyberport. And as for smart living application platform, again, this is a major application cluster being built up by Cyberport, and there are over 770 enterprises involved. Science Park is mainly for research and development of new technology. Each enterprise will have to devote more than 50% of its funding on R&D before it can be qualified. And Cyberport is for transformation of digital technology. But for sure, we will ensure that there is proper coordination of resources among them. Well, if all parties are working on similar areas from a startup or an point of view, if I want to look for an organization that can help me to develop smart living, then which organization should I turn to? I don't want to see vicious competition between them, because that may not be the best use of resources. Undersecretary, yes, as I said, Cyberport and Science Park have very clear delineation of roles, and we will maintain very close communication with these corporations. Science Park is on AI, sophisticated engineering, etc. For Cyberport, is a fintech, digital entertainment, and smart living. Thank you, Mr. Lam Chun Sing. Cyberport will start its five-phase expansion, and the government is already inviting tenders, hopefully 100 INT companies, some of which are strategic companies with vast potential, can be attracted to Hong Kong. I'd like to know how your expansion program can support the administration's plan to attract strategic INT enterprises to come to Hong Kong. You also talked about the startup plans for provided by Cyberport. However, the number of applications has dropped from 700 odd in 2017 to just over 400 recently. But according to the government's figures, we have seen an annual growth in the number of startups. How come fewer startups have applied for funding from Cyberport? Is it because your criteria are too strict? Have you got any feedback from the sector so that you can help more startups? The last question is on the financial situation of Cyberport. in 2021-22, you suffer a loss of over $67 million. When you submitted your budget to LegCo, you already budgeted a deficit, but then the deficit turns out to be bigger than your projection. So do you think you will have to tap into your reserves of over $200 million? Thank you. A short response. An expansion of Cyberport is critical to our trove for enterprises because in Hong Kong, we don't have enough space for INT activities. Enterprises need the right conditions to operate, and that include space. So Cyberport, under its expansion program, will provide more space for these enterprises. And we also want to develop digital industries. So Cyberport will have new hardware and software to support this. For instance, as explained by the CEO, they are going to have a digital service platform, a data services platform. They will provide training on cybersecurity and new clouding services platform. These are all important. Phase 5 of Cyberport will attract more emerging technology companies. As regards how come there are fewer startups applying for funding, actually, the annual intake has remained at around 130. And some of the enterprises understand that competition is keen. Understand that even for startups that are not successful in obtaining funding, the Cyberport will give them support so that they can have a higher chance of success next time. The CEO can supplement. The third question is about the financial position of Cyberport. I thank the member for his concern. I believe Cyberport is going to balance the books within a couple of years. In 2019, the loss was partly due to COVID, which had dealt a blow to the sector. And then a large portion of Cyberport's revenue came from its hotel, but then it was closed for quite a large portion of the time during COVID. But it has now reopened with the completion of the expansion project. I believe Cyberport can balance its books very soon. Thank you. I don't think there is time for Mr. Yen to respond. Mr. Xu Kafai, my question relates to paragraph 12. Nurturing of talents. Now, for 3 years in a row, they have got this Cyberport University Partnership Program to nurture fintech talent. Can you explain to us whether you have any follow-up after training these fintech talents? And then the CEO mentioned in his PowerPoint that they have 800 tenants. But then they are not operating in Cyberport. They are operating outside Cyberport. I'd like to know the mode of cooperation. And you keep mentioning the six unicorns you have nurtured. One has become a listed company. You are so proud of that. I'd like to know whether Cyberport has any shareholding in the listing company. Thank you. Thank you. There are three questions from Mr. Xiu. I will respond to the first, and then the CEO can supplement. We have trained up many fintech talents, and we do have follow-up measures. Take the fintech talent training scheme. We have trained over 7,000. They are practitioners. They may be serving in the banking sector, insurance sector, or securities sector. Now, for the petitioner himself, and for the more common application of fintech in industry and the promotion of deployment of fintech, these are very important. Cyberport also jointly organized these programs with the trade as well as Hong Kong MA. The CEO can supplement.
I'll quickly supplement. We have taken up follow-up actions on the nurturing program. This year, we are holding for the second time the talent training program. And building on our previous success, we have nurtured another 2,600 people. We have also expanded the program and extended it to other organizations in the industry. And through the support of Cyberport, these organizations also hold training programs, which saw some 3,000 participants. So altogether, this round, there are 6,000 participants in total. In this regard, we have the recognition of the industry. Perhaps we did not make ourselves clear just now. At Cyberport, there are some 800 companies. They include about 100 using our office spaces. They have been paying rent. And another 600 companies at Cyberport, they are smart space users, and they also have to pay rent. Also, we mentioned about companies that stay stationed in Cyberport and outside of Cyberport. We allow companies who participate in our incubation program to have an option to use the offices provided at Cyberport. Some of them, they may already have their offices or setups outside of Cyberport, so they can have the option of not using the office space provided by Cyberport. For those stationing at Cyberport, we have about 50 of them. For those who are not stationing at Cyberport, as mentioned, there are about 100 to 200 of them, which are incubatees of Cyberport, which are operating outside of the campus of the Cyberport, but they have been using the resources provided by us. Do you have anything to supplement on the benefits brought by listed companies? Regarding whether we have any shares in these listed companies, well, currently, under our incubation program, we've been giving support and financial assistance to the incubatees, and we will not hold any shares as a return, except for those investment. We have invested in some 25 companies, and we have shares in those companies. Of course, we will gain returns from these companies that we invest in. Otherwise, for the other companies, they will get a funding of $1.1 billion, and we won't get anything in return. Next, Mr. Dennis Leung, as shown from the PowerPoint presentation, there was the area of nurturing talent. For instance, there is the Cyberport Career Fair, as well as the GBA Youth Employment Scheme, JC Procruit C, as well as FinTech Anti-Epidemic Scheme for Talent Development, etc. I want to know if the administration can provide us figures on how much money it has invested in these programs and how many young people have participated in these programs, and as of now, how many of the young participants are still staying in the industry to pursue a career, so that we have a better idea of whether these schemes and programs are actually nurturing enough talents to serve in the industry. Also, we have the knowing more about IT program and other programs that are continuously implemented by the administration. Are these programs really nurturing more talents in primary and secondary schools? If we continue to roll out these programs, I'm just wondering if we have enough talents to serve in the IT sector through these programs. Are there any new ideas proposed by the government to nurture more talents? The first question is about whether the schemes are nurturing young people and also those and other people. And on the other question, I wonder if the Undersecretary has anything to say as well. I will give a quick response on the second question, and for the first question, I'll defer it to Mr. Yan. On nurturing IT talents in Hong Kong, this is an area that we attach importance to, and this is the most important part in developing the IT sector. We're doing it as a chain. For instance, in primary schools, we have the Knowing More About IT program. And in secondary school, we have the Innovation Lab program. And in university level, we also offer scholarship and the STEM internship program so that students can, since they are little, nurture their interest in IT. And through participation in these programs, they can be exposed to various INT programs, and it may stimulate their interest in studying IT-related programs when they are in universities. And perhaps in the future, they may develop a career in IT. And also, we have the Cyberport Academy, which brings students on tours at Cyberport. Apart from the programs and schemes mentioned, what is critical is that we have to work with the Education Bureau to promote these programs in a comprehensive manner. And the Education Bureau also have a goal to achieve in terms of developing STEAM programs. On the first question, I'll defer to the CEO. On the question about the FinTech Anti-Epidemic Scheme for Talent Development, please be rest assured that it is a program specifically designed for FinTech practitioners. So participants of this program, they are in-service financial practitioners. As of now, we have received 1,300 applications, among them 800 employers have already recruited their employees, and we have approved 900 applications, and 800 of them were able to recruit employees under the program. Through FSTB's program, every month, applicants or successful applicants receive $10,000 of funding for 12 months. So companies who are not engaging in fintech businesses, they will no longer obtain the funding. This is to ensure that the scheme is really benefiting the relevant organizations for nurturing talents. We also have the internship program, and we have been collaborating with technology giants in this program. And they have to get certain qualifications in order to take part in the program. So we have to make sure they have the qualifications, and in future, they can choose whether they want to continue to develop a career in IT sector. I understand that there is not a delineation of young people or other group of people for the program. Is that right? Correct. There are five other members who have pressed the button to speak. I will draw the line here, and I'll extend the meeting for 15 minutes. Any other members who would like to speak? All right. Next, Ms. Elizabeth Quart. Thank you, Chair. Over the years, Cyberport in the areas of fintech, digital entertainment, etc., have done a lot of work, and we have seen the results they have achieved, and I congratulate their effort. on fintech. I see that Cyberport has helped nurture a lot of talents in fintech. However, I think that you're currently emphasizing more importance on how to apply the relevant technology in fintech sector. However, we also need other types of technology talents. Do you have plans in the future to nurture more types of talents? Secondly, on smart living, we see that there are 760 companies in under this cluster. As mentioned, it is more important that we have to let the general public know what we have achieved in smart living. A lot of times, members of the general public are unaware that or are unaware what we have achieved to develop ourselves into a smart city. In the future, will you do more in publicity in community level and also ask your startups to go to the community to showcase their efforts instead of just holding exhibitions so that the general public can know what technology you have developed? Perhaps you can think about asking the startups to develop their businesses in the community so that the general public can actually make use of the technology they develop. Also, digital entertainment. It seems that the results achieved in this area is not as significant. Well, we have seen a lot of talks about Web 3.0 in the market. Do you have any plans in digital entertainment or in developing Web 3.0 also? Are you encountering any bottlenecks or constraints? What are the biggest difficulties that you are encountering? And what kind of support you need from the government or the Legislative Council? Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Ms. Quart. Ms. Quart has been giving her support in our development. Member mentioned whether we can ask enterprises or startups to do more publicity work in the community. This is definitely necessary in developing ourselves as a smart city. Well, we're currently holding a roving exhibition to present to the public what kind of solutions we are adopting within the government. We are taking into consideration members' suggestion, and we will consider bringing enterprises and startups to the community. Well, we're not encountering any bottlenecks, but we would like to have the support of Ms. Quart and other members in the future so that we can strengthen our publicity work in the community, and hopefully we can collaborate more with community organizations so that the general public can make good use of the technology. We are also committed to nurturing more talents. I'll see if the CEO has anything to supplement later. On digital entertainment and Web 3.0, this is the major trend. The administration is accelerating its development of Web 3.0 ecosystem in Hong Kong, and with the approval from LegCo, we will allocate $50 million onto the development. We'll set up a base for developing Web 3.0, and we'll also set up a dedicated academy for developing Web 3.0. We'll have relevant training programs as well. We've been talking to universities to see how we can nurture relevant talents in this area. We are preparing to set up a Web 3.0 lab to showcase the relevant solutions and proposals. We are actively working with the relevant Web 3.0 community to attract more relevant enterprises to establish their presence in Hong Kong, especially in Cyberport. Over the last few months, we have over 140 of such enterprises establishing presence here already. We hope to ride on this trend continuously. Next, Dr. Lo Wai Kwok.
Under the leadership of the chief executive, council members went on a mission trip to GBA, and then we visited Tianhai, the DreamWorks, and we were all rather impressed. Of course, that was not my first time visiting there, but then it has done really something good for our young entrepreneurs. So we found out that about 460 Hong Kong young people have set up their companies there, accounting for over half of the enterprises there. So it is really a very good base for young startups there. I think the Cyberport has made very good development. As for weather, we should make a distinction on the age of applicants. Of course, you cannot check on the age of the applicants first before you approve them. But if you have something like the DreamWorks in Tianhai, that I welcome that, because we can have a GBA DreamWorks there. We do not just want to attract the strategic companies. We also want to have innovative young people in our youth space, because they may well be the future unicorns. So representatives from Cyberport and the administration, how can you turn Cyberport, or how can you ensure that Cyberport can maximize is a use? Thank you. I will very quickly respond to the point made by Mr. Lo Wai Kwok, and that is our young entrepreneurs. The SL government sets a lot of store by youth work, and the government is promoting our work for young people. We help young people to have their own startups. There are also internship program for them. We have a STEM internship program for our young people. And under the Home Affairs, Home and Youth Affairs Bureau, they have schemes to support our young people to join youth startup internship programs in GBA. And of course, the Bureau works very closely with us, targeting young people. We have provided subsidies up to $600,000 for a young person who has successfully applied for it. And whether we can have a youth space in Hong Kong similar to the GBA youth space is a very good suggestion. Cyberport has a lot of cooperation programs with Tianhai. Perhaps a CEO can supplement. Yes, whether we can have a dedicated space for young people in Cyberport like the GBA youth space. Now, we do not differentiate between the age of our applicants. But outside Cyberport, we have in Chun Wan a Cyberport space set up a few years ago. Spot Space 8 of Cyberport is designed specially for our young people. The applicants have to be under 35 years old before they are qualified to live in Smart Space 8. So we've already got a particular area for our young people, in addition to many other programs tailor-made for young people. And for more than 11 years, we have set up a Cyberport Youth Entrepreneurship Program. It started more than a decade ago. It was for Shenzhen and Hong Kong, and then it expanded to Hong Kong and Guangzhou, and now it is a Hong Kong GBA Entrepreneurship Program. Over 1,000 young people have taken part in the program to start their business. A successful applicant can obtain $100,000 of subsidy. So quite a lot of young people, university graduates in particular, have taken part in that program. We need to step up publicity. And this so-called smart space, I think that is too vague. In Tianhai, they have a very clear name. It's called Hong Kong Shenzhen Youth Space. So I think you need to step up publicity. Thank you. Mr. Lok Chong Hong, thank you. How we can properly maximize the Cyberport as a platform. This is a subject close to many, and it has also been quite successful because it has nurtured 6 unicorns already. The government is going to launch the RAISE program. It's about how the universities, the also the business sector and also the research sector can work together to commercialize R&D products. I think the INT sector has to have some business sense. For instance, if they have a certain idea, they can approach universities to see whether they can provide the right technology. So I'd like to know what Cyberport is going to do so that there can be more opportunities for cooperation between the business sector and the universities. That is the Cyberport playing the role of a matchmaker. In 2021, this panel discussed the development of Cyberport as well. Perhaps it was because we were in the middle of COVID. We found that the circulation of commercial space of Cyberport was rather limited. We'd like to know what you have done to boost visitors to Cyberport. Of course, during weekdays, companies are in business and they may not have room to cater for visitors. But then over the weekend, you have an excellent waterfront there. We should allow families and young kids to have access to technology programs or activities there, so the Cyberport can be a popular spot for families that will help the business of the retailers, and then you can boost revenue through rent. Thank you. Mr. Lok, now the collaboration of the industries and the academia and the research sector. Yes, in the INT ecosystem, we must have participation and collaboration of different parties. Our plan is within 5 years, hopefully in our universities, we can have 100 new technology projects that can become startups for commercialization of R&D outcome. We want to have the participation of the business sector from our industries and also from the investment sector because they have more expertise in and more business sense in the commercialization of R&D products. The Cyberport and also our various R&D centers and our science park are also involved because they have a very wide investors network. They have good knowledge of the industries and they can play the role of a bridge among these sectors. As for how we can boost the visitor circulation of a small, now they have F&B facilities, they are trying to enrich the mix of F&B companies, they have weekday workshops, they have various measures to attract more visitors. Now, because of our time constraints, are you done, Undersecretary? Members, can we extend the meeting by another 10 minutes? Or else we will have to shorten the time for the remaining two members. Allow me to supplement. When it comes to collaboration with universities and the industries, of course, we will enhance our role. But we have had various partnership programs with universities. To encourage entrepreneurship among students. University students can join our incubation program through fast track channels. So we're already working with two universities, and for the rest, things are in progress. When it comes to our number of visitors to our mall, we have already done a lot of work. We have organized events. And if you take the whole Cyberport as a whole, apart except for the offices, we are now pet-friendly at weekends. Pet owners are bringing their pets to our waterfront park. That has helped to attract visitors to our shopping mall in the past 2 years. And of course, we have stopped this during COVID, but now at weekends, we have free film shows. The purpose is to attract more visitors to our shopping mall for higher consumption. Thank you. Ms. Yong Hoyan, I'd like to focus on esports and digital entertainment. This is a subject always close to the heart of members in terms of training and provision of space for esports. We understand that Cyberport has already done a lot. In September, we have the Hangzhou Asia Games. Luckily, Hong Kong can be involved in the esports events. I'd like to know whether Cyberport is going to promote the esports events in Asia Games and whether Cyberport can help in grasping this business opportunity. And it's also a demonstration to our young people that there is potential for development in esports, and we also want to promote the flow of people within GBA. And that applies to esports as well. In 2018-19, we successfully secured funding from the FS. $100 million was granted by the FS for building the esports venue there. It's been 4 years since. Do you see any bottleneck in the promotion of esports in Hong Kong? And do you have any new thinking for developing new esports in Hong Kong? Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Yong, who has always been a staunch supporter of the development of esports and digital entertainment industry in Cyberport. The CEO can supplement later. Now they are promoting more esports events, and they are also developing the infrastructure as well as the industry chain of digital entertainment. Esports is among our digital entertainment business. There are over 170 digital entertainment related companies, some involved in big data analysis, some in a game development, and there is also peripheral R&D and also esports equipment. We are now working on perfecting the whole ecosystem. For sure, we will deepen the development of digital entertainment. As for talents, I defer to the CEO.
Thank you, Ms. Yong, for your support in this area of development on esports. Let me brief members on the efforts we have achieved. We have organized about 140 esports related events and competitions, and we have also offered scholarship. In our program, there are internship support schemes, over 80 job opportunities have been created. In terms of nurturing talents with universities, we have been actively working on it as well. We have seen the establishment of various high diploma programs in universities. Over 500 students have taken part in these programs. Apart from the support at the lower level provided, we have also nurtured talents and we have seen the results. In the long run, we're seeing a broader development of esports, and metaverse has become more and more popular. The delineation between the two has become blurred though. For metaverse games or sports related games, they fall under the categorization of esports, it seems. So we will monitor the development of metaverse platforms, and we will continue to strengthen our development in Web 3.0. Mr. Li Chenkeng. Thank you, Chair. Speaker off the mic. Has the microphone been turned on? Am I coming through? Yes. 20 years ago, when I was still a kid, I already heard of the name Cyberport. At that time, people from the general public thought it was a development or real estate project. Over the past few years, though, under the help of ITIB, I can see that a lot of efforts have been achieved by Cyberport. Cyberport was also known as the Eastern Hollywood. I see that you will put an effort in developing digital and entertainment. How are you going to nurture talents in this area? As Ms. Yong said, we'll see esports development and we will see the Asian sports game. And some members mentioned about the DreamWorks development, etc. How can we integrate better with the Greater Bay Area market? Do you have any plans in this regard? Secondly, in your plans, Do you think that you should focus or put more emphasis on specific areas so that we can tell good stories of China and promote Hong Kong as the Eastern Hollywood? Thank you. Undersecretary, thank you, Mr. Lee, for your commendation and recognition of the work of Cyberport. As you said, it's not easy over the past 20 years, and we've seen some 1,900 companies at Cyberport already. We have a large number of unicorns, and there are companies who have done very well, and they were all nurtured by the Cyberport. So Cyberport has contributed a lot to the industry. So thank you, members, for your recognition of our efforts. Of course, we will keep up with our good work on the development of digital entertainment and its integration with the Greater Bay Area. I'll defer it to the CEO. Thank you. Thank you, member, for your recognition of our effort. As mentioned by the Undersecretary, we will continue to strengthen our effort in integrating ourselves with the Greater Bay Area. We have various cooperation agreements with universities in relation to the schools or campuses they have already set up in the Greater Bay Area, and we can do our publicity work in those schools. Apart from collaborating with universities, we also have a cooperation agreement with Shanghai. Just last week, I went to Shanghai and talked to the relevant parties about our cooperation. We have to tie in with the new strategies implemented by Shanghai, and one of the strategies is related to fintech and also professional service development or high-end professional service development. These are all strengths of the Cyberport. On specific areas that highlight our strengths, I think there is one area that facilitates our integration with the mainland. One is related to financial services, that is virtual asset development. This cannot be done in the mainland, but we can do it in Hong Kong. We have a lot of technical talents in this area. And so how can we attract more talents to attract them to pursue a career in Hong Kong? Well, apart from virtual asset, there are other areas that we can develop or have seen good development in Hong Kong. For instance, one of the unicorns have done well in NFT and metaverse. In the mainland, NFT is an area that can be developed. How can we make use of our edges and integrate ourselves with the mainland? This is one thing that we are working on. Chair, one follow-up question. It's good to know that you have such broad horizon, and we have to work with the Greater Bay Area and see how we can develop blockchain technologies, etc. Apart from schools set up in the Greater Bay Area, there are also international schools or affiliated schools from Hong Kong that have established their campuses on the mainland. I hope that you can have more exchange programs with these schools. If you need any help from us, please let us know. Thank you, member, for the questions. I saw that Ms. Yong pressed the button to speak. Well, but due to time constraint, we can't let members ask more questions. In our next meeting, we'll again talk about internship programs held by the Cyberport. Perhaps you can provide us with more statistics, for instance, the number of companies to show the outcomes achieved by Cyberport, for instance, how many students were able to find jobs after participating in the relevant programs and whether they were able to earn higher salary after taking part in the programs. Perhaps you can provide more figures or statistics in this area in the next meeting. So we have wrapped up this agenda item. Finally, AOB. Nothing falling under AOB, so meeting adjourned. Thank you.